I hear you when I see you. I feel you when I think of you. You remain in the deepest space within me, always present even when you're not around me. Hone your listening skills. Let's imagine a situation. Lots of students simultaneously are speaking to the teacher. How do you expect the teacher to be able to hear any one of them? Or, now let's imagine a situation. You are talking to your child as a parent or as a teacher, and your child is busy on the phone. And the first thing that you say is, look at me. Where is your attention? Why aren't you looking at me? Where is your eye-to-eye contact? So if we want to look at communication, then the first thing that comes is listening. And I think it's very important that all of us adults need to also hone up our listening skills. What do you do to ensure that your child feels you are listening to them? So if you are busy, what you should do is you should tell your children, I'm busy right now. Why don't we talk, let's say, after half an hour, 20 minutes, maybe not today, it's not a good day, we'll discuss it tomorrow. There is no harm in creating a space or a boundary when you're busy. But the problem is, whilst your child is speaking, and if at that time you are distracted either by your work or you are doing something else, or you interrupt them and then without having a conversation move on to something that is important for you at that time, your children may feel like secondary citizens. They may feel that what is important to them or what they want to tell you may not be a priority for you. And that's something parents must avoid, because what it does is then children start becoming hesitant. They feel, is this the right time? Would they be interested? Do my thoughts matter? Do my views matter? Should I rather not say it? Should I just talk to a friend? Should I bottle it up? It is these kind of confusions that creep into children, which also impair their confidence and self-esteem. So if you want children to open up and talk to you, you'll need to focus on your listening skills. Maintain eye-to-eye contact. Use affirmations, active listening, use your yes, go on, show your expressions and emotions when they are speaking, facilitate the completion of their thought process so that they feel they've been able to share, validate what they have said, give your feedback, create that comfortable zone where they can continue to come and talk to you. Do not interrupt. Do not rush to a judgment. Do not reprimand. Even if you're not liking what you are hearing, let it complete and then give a constructive feedback. And also make sure that your body language is in the moment, that your body language is not that you are restless or you are busy about going somewhere else or doing something else, as if you want this conversation to get over. It is some of these cues that makes the person who's talking to us feel that the listener is not fully there. So for all of us, and this is not just for parents and teachers, frankly, listening is a skill for life, for everybody. I mean, you may be talking to your friend, you may be talking to your colleague, your supervisors, your seniors, your juniors, at workplace, or whatever the age group of children is. You may be a grandparent, or you're talking to your siblings. The fact is, listening needs to be with the genuine intent of being in that conversation. That's how you raise confident children.